What's happening, everybody? Welcome back to One Life to Game. Very happy to have you back here with another NBA 2K16 video for the Xbox One. This time we will be doing a rematch of the Western Conference Finals from last season, where we will have the Golden State Warriors hosting the Memphis Grizzlies. Really excited for this one. Hope you are as well. So thanks so much for tuning in. I will be controlling the Golden State Warriors. And let's go ahead to the studio for the pregame show. Enjoy, everybody. Thanks so much for watching.
The 2K Sports Pregame Show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. Tonight, it'll be the Golden State Warriors going up against the Memphis Grizzlies. And for Memphis, they're looking to come out strong and make their mark early. They have to look at this game as a great opportunity to do just that. And Klay Thompson, the son of former first overall pick Michael Thompson, I mean, when he gets hot, he can take over games.
Hey, you know what? This guy, didn't he have 37 in a quarter last year?
Yeah.
How incredible is that to get 37 in a quarter?
Not only that, Kenny also had 26 in a quarter later on.
Get out of here.
Yeah, he can shoot over anyone with his height, and he has a quick release. You know, he probably has the prettiest shot in the game.
I would agree with that.
37 and a quarter.
Right.
And your career high was?
41.
41 is your career high. 37 and a quarter. Right. Does that impress Shaquille O'Neal?
Yeah.
What's your high in a quarter?
I don't know. I didn't get the ball that much. You know who I played with.
He had 50, he had 60.
Shaq is great in this game. As he is in real life.
I heard you, Shaq. I heard you.
I could be subliminal.
Let's get it to Kevin Harlan.
He didn't get the ball that much.
I didn't get it to him.
It's the Western Conference on display, featuring the Memphis Grizzlies. The excitement of the NBA is on the way. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony.
So I'm excited as I've been playing this game a little bit more in the past few days, just to see now that I've got a fantastic point guard on my team, to see if I can have some better control with him, do some better passing to get everyone involved. So we got the tip off here, and that's won by Bogut. And oddly, we have Draymond Green bringing the ball up the floor.
A lot of defense with Conley and
Lee. Let's see how things go this game.
At the pivot spot, manning the middle.
that's a good sign of things to come if Harrison Barnes can get to the hoop that easily on this Grizzlies defense. Nice little start here for Golden State, up 2 zip with 4:40 left to play in the first quarter.
Clark, looking around the league, there's no team that teams want to
I like those Klay Thompson big heads in the background there. Quick steal.
Physical brand of basketball, they play hard, everybody's on the same page.
And Courtney Lee takes it right back for Memphis.
How they try to wear you down.
Now here's Lee.
Little flop there by Klay Thompson, another steal. There we go. Easy fast break there. Opportunity for Klay Thompson. So two quick dunks for Golden State to get up to this 4-0 lead. And you know the crowd at the Oracle Arena would be electrified after that. Probably some of the best fans in the NBA.
Part of it is that they just have a style that matches up well.
Jeez. Jeff Green looks like he's sweating as if we've played about four quarters and are in overtime right now. Ooh.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. Jeff Green picks one up.
So look at that, like that spin move there.
With the Memphis Grizzlies, I mean, there isn't a team that gives them too much trouble anywhere.
Let's break down the defense a little bit.
They're used to playing in tight, low-scoring games. And they create that situation with their deliberate style.
And Steph Curry, 6'3", and about 195. I mean, a slender frame. You look back to...
Look at that realism before I shoot the free throw here of Steph Curry's playing with the mouth guard. That is definitely him. So
And speaking of
this game, does not miss too much.
He's worked up and bulked himself up. He's added some muscle. He even got up to 200 pounds, I think he said. But he didn't feel real good, Clark, at that weight.
Yeah, it's not about the weight, Kevin. It's about strength. You need it to fight through screens and attack the rim. And he's clearly put on the strength he needs to play at his highest level.
And remember, you go back to when Steph Curry was in college, more of a shooting guard at Davidson, but he's worked relentlessly.
Memphis works the ball inside to Zach Randolph. A little bit of a ticky-tack foul there, but Zach Randolph will head to the line for two. Draymond Green picks that foul up. So, yeah, definitely take an opportunity to comment on the video. Write anything, you know, let me know who your favorite NBA team is. Let me know what you think about this video or about the game as a whole. Maybe things that you've noticed that you like about the game. Definitely want to hear a lot of feedback from the viewers. So, yeah, write in and subscribe. Please subscribe. I'd love to have you guys come back for future videos.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
Zach Randolph getting up there in his mid-30s, but his game has never been based on explosiveness. So it's all about strength, skill, and craft when you talk about Z-Bo. And he's aging gracefully.
Now here is Bogut.
Somebody want to try to get open there? Nope. Bad pass by me, though, that cross-court pass.
Here's Lee. Off the break.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
So we're all tied up here at six with about 3 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Pretty low scoring here for these explosive teams.
And Randolph Clark can struggle in matchups against quicker power forwards of those spread fours.
Nice shot there by Draymond Green. Zach Randolph displays a little frustration letting that one go. 9-6 lead here for Golden State. Not typically the guy you'd see taking the early three-point shot in the game for Golden State, but still capable of making them.
Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. Here's Curry, and it's Gasol with the rebound. The Grizzlies trail by three. Outside Conley. There's the triple.
Lucky that he didn't make that one, because I wasn't really playing great defense in that possession.
Curry with it. Outside Green. Outside for Curry.
Great passing by Bogut out of the post there to find an open Steph Curry. Just needed a little bit of room to hit that three.
Because he's given up a lot of,
and it looks like we're going to have some substitutions get ready to check in a moment here. Not sure why Gasol didn't attack the hoop on that one. I gave him a wide open lane. Nice strip by the big man.
And now Curry running the floor all by himself.
Oh, unselfish play by Curry, but Draymond Green either missed the dunk or it was deflected.
Makes it off the glass.
And Memphis converts on that turnover there by me. Hanging in the game. Pretty fast-paced start here. And you'd expect nothing less from these Western Conference teams, especially the Warriors, as we've reached our first timeout break at the Oracle Arena.
Decide to take their first timeout here.
And you are watching NBA 2K16 for the Xbox One.
Carve out space, the space he needs to play well.
Yeah, he's unorthodox. With
patient offense. I'm not sure that's really two words you ever see correlated together with the Golden State Warriors, but we'll let it ride for now. So we got Sean Livingston checking in. The NBA Finals MVP, Andre Iguodala. We've got Barbosa. So just
here's Barbosa.
Golden State continues to attack you with firepower and athleticism at all times. As you see Leandro Barbosa get to the basket there for a layup, using his quickness to get around the defense.
Great playground, old school there, partner.
Here's Hudrick. The Warriors making the shot. Right sets a screen. Off
And Beno Udrih with the layup there.
Well, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like that.
It's like a running game in football. When you can pound the basketball inside, it also allows you to control the team's transition.
Pretty happy last year for Sean Livingston for him to not only get back from his injury. And then looks like he's found a nice home here with the Warriors. And for him to get a championship ring was a nice moment for him, I'm sure. A lot of hard work to get back onto the floor. No one near him. And a quick 4 points for Beno Udrih as he was able to get open there on that screen.
Here is Livingston. He's guarded by Udrih. Here's the three.
A little overzealous on that shot. And we've reached the end of the first quarter with Golden State leading 16-12 on NBA 2K16 for Xbox One. This is One Life to Game. Thanks a lot for watching. Definitely give me those thumbs up if you've enjoyed the video, and I would greatly appreciate it.
Steph Curry, a player within the gym range, told us about his comfort stretching the floor.
Anywhere 5-6 feet outside that three-point line, if I have a dribble, if I catch and shoot, if I have a good look, you know, I think Coach will allow me to take that shot. And it's tough to guard, especially when you see a couple go in. That basket gets a lot bigger.
I was going to say, Greg, how big must that hoop look to Steph Curry? And tough to guard might be the understatement of the day.
I mean, he is just an insanely great shooter. I mean, arguably, I don't think there's an argument. He's the best shooter in the world. The argument is whether or not he's the best shooter ever.
Ever.
And listen, I can imagine there's very few times that Coach Curry is not going to allow this splash brother to let her rip.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And the Warriors, guys, what jumps out to you in this game, stats-wise?
Really active hands early on here as they're able.
So as we get the second quarter started here in Oakland, I'd like to try to get Klay Thompson involved. He didn't really get too much action early in the game, so we'll see if I can get anything to him without forcing it.
And it's Conley in at the point guard position. Now here's Thompson, 4 on the clock.
Oh, that was a pretty good attempt there. Just didn't fall through for me.
It's been this mindset that Golden State wins through offense, but their defense, you know, Gia, you were talking about this, is where the true strength of this team lies.
Yeah, I think that's what's really allowed them to separate.
Pretty nice defense being played here by Golden State, forcing Memphis into some contested low percentage shots here early on.
Now here's Thompson. Jeff Green missing his last shot. Thompson, left side.
There we go.
Thompson's got the lead up to 6 now for the Warriors.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense.
Right, looks like we got a timeout here by Memphis. And Klay Thompson psyched up to score his first shot get his first shot in the second quarter. See, that's kind of generic, because I've seen this assistant coach, I'm assuming that is. I don't know if that's supposed to be me. I don't know who that is, but I've seen that guy in multiple teams, that same exact dude. So maybe somebody can comment on that. Is that supposed to be the person that you are, or is that just a generic assistant coach? Because I think that's about the third team I've seen that same guy on. Now, if it is the same guy, then he's getting paid a lot of money. So, and I would love to see his travel itinerary also.
Lee outside. Randolph a screen.
It's pretty apparent that Memphis is trying to slow the pace of the game down, but
dishes to Green.
And I like the fact
as soon as Golden State gets it, they go right out on the break, though, and play their game.
He saved a layup with that foul, and he'll make him earn them from the line, and that's what you want to see.
Good clean foul there. Tr- Draymond Green will go to the line for two.
Taking over the starting power forward role in Golden State last season. David Lee was injured, remember, in preseason. Green was inserted, and he's been terrific ever since.
Absolutely superb. A former second round.
Pretty simple to hit free throws in this game. If you look at the bar that is underneath the player, so right above the name, as soon as that gets close to the middle, you just want to release the right thumbstick.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots. The Grizzlies trail by eight.
I'll have to try that with DeAndre Jordan and see see how easy it is for him.
Pass to Green.
His probably never hits the middle. It just. And another fast break opportunity here. He'll take it back out as the defense collapsed on me.
In terms of that small forward, power forward at only 6'7", but he's got toughness. The long arms enable him to defend bigger guys, and also the basketball.
Nice shot there by Klay Thompson. Good ball movement there to look for an open opportunity. Jumped out to a nice 10-point lead here, 22-12.
There's the screen. Lee against Kerr, picked by Randall.
He's got to hit that shot. Oh, they're just... All right. Vince Carter getting into the action here. The nice offensive rebound. And he'll go to the line there. Nice pump fake there to get Barnes up in the air.
And with Draymond Green, he can defend inside. He can cover on the perimeter. I mean, his versatility at both ends of the floor, also a huge asset. And you can't have a higher basketball IQ than he does. It really helps him excel at all facets of the game.
Andre Iguodala has checked in for the Warriors.
There you go. Try to psych him out a little bit by hitting the right trigger and left trigger.
Vince Carter hits them both.
Although Vince Carter is unshakable. He's been through it all.
Look at some old clips of Vince Carter in his prime. Clark, one of the great dunkers the league has ever seen.
And for my money, the greatest game dunk in pro basketball history.
Oh, nice behind the back dribble there by Curry. And a spin move. And Bogut can't clean up the easy bucket there. Look at Vince Carter there leading the break. Nice pass.
Love the assist. I mean, he knew exactly where that bounce pass had to be to create that opportunity. And you think back to Vince Carter starting his career with the Raptors, an 8-time All-Star, 2-time All-NBA selection, and he really introduced Canada to the NBA game.
Now here is Bogut. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him.
Oh, and a tough, tough shot there for Steph Curry, and he just gets the friendly bounce there. Nice touch on the ball. Good screen set by Bogut to allow that play to occur.
Now here's Lee. Pass to Conley. Gets that one to fall after missing his first two.
All right, Memphis is starting to hit some shots here in the last few moments of the game.
Superstar in his prime.
So we'll take a quick break here at the Oracle Arena. Again, this is NBA 2K16 for the Xbox One. You're watching the YouTube channel for One Life to Game. I appreciate you stopping by. Comment on the video. Let me know what you think. And subscribe for more content.
Flamboyant offensive threat, but he's a steady player at both ends of the floor. Makes threes at a high clip and competes defensively. One of those guys that you don't necessarily win because of, but you sure will win with.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. Festus Ezeli, he's jacked in for Bogut. Barbosa comes in for Klay Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense didn't give up on that play and cut him off.
And Courtney Lee out of Western Kentucky, not usually a hotbed of NBA talent, but, Clark, he's having a nice career.
He really is. I mean, playing big minutes for the Grizzlies, Kevin, and they really need his floor space.
All right, sorry about that, folks. I don't know. Looks like I had a quick battery issue. And we're back into it here.
And his hard-nosed, versatile defensive ability. You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
Just beautiful when they play the game like this.
Now here's Iguodala, looking for his first basket still in this one. From 10 feet out, and Green gets it to go. And the Warriors lead by 5. For Memphis, they've gone 3-7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. And the call will be against Sean Livingston. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Udrich. Dishes it to Gasol. It's good. This time the assist from Udrich.
And that's his strong suit, the ability to find his way through the D and finish at the rim.
Livingston.
All right, so we've reached the end of the first half. Just a slight lead for Golden State here, 26-23, so pretty good game as Memphis was able to cut into the lead there during the second quarter. And go ahead and check out this interview here.
How important the physical presence would be in this game. How important is that going to be for the team in the second half?
That's a big deal. I mean, just being physical and, make the right plays, and then hopefully put ourselves in good position to win.
You've got to match that opponent's intensity, Steph. Thanks for the time. Guys?
Thank you, Doris. And we'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Well, two quarters down, two to go. Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith as we start breaking it down for you. Golden State found themselves in a close game in the first. At the end of the period, they held a 4-point lead. They didn't stop fighting in the second quarter as they maintained most of their first quarter lead and now lead by 3 at the break. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
They're playing with a sense of urgency, even though they're at home. Sometimes you feel so comfortable on your home court, the other team can jump on you. But they know these fans have their back, and now they're well positioned to build a lead in the second half.
Shaq, your take on Memphis.
They ran their offense very well in the first half. There were almost no forced shots. It was good, smart basketball. The motion in their offense was terrific. They made those defenders work very hard. I like what I saw from them for the most part.
And that'll do it for now as the second half of our game is about to get underway. Kevin Harlan has the call.
And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now. One guy who's been getting it done so far, Stephen Curry.
And what he gives his team, guys, is an edge. He just lights up an arena when he gets it going. And in that first half, young fella had it going.
All right, welcome back, everybody, to the Oracle Arena for the second half of basketball action here. And I've got my 3-point lead against Memphis. We'll see if we can get that lead to balloon a little bit. But otherwise, it's been a pretty neck and neck game. I had, I believe, a double-digit lead earlier, and that went away rather quickly. So it should be a nice close to the game here. And I'm sorry, I don't know what's going on with the controller. I've just put new batteries in here, so I apologize for that. I may have to, if it happens again, though, I may have to switch them out. I don't know. So I do apologize for that.
Connect from short range.
And guys, one thing that we were treated with last year was Steve Kerr's great quotability in post-game interviews and pressers. He said all the right things and deflected praise like a coach who had done it for many years.
Here's Conley after the made shot from Klay Thompson. kicks to Randolph. It's stolen by Green. And up the court come the Warriors on the break. Barnes got the ball.
Quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively.
Hopefully you guys all like that one. Nice fast break there, and that leads to a early Memphis timeout here so they can talk it over.
You know, the Warriors took some,
because they were just getting back into this game, and the last thing they want to do is let Golden State go out to one of those runs where all of a sudden you're down by 20 points and you don't know what hit you.
Situation far more flexible.
Now a timeout called by Memphis. And Draymond Green will give you the superstar numbers.
I like that strategy. Play through Klay Thompson. So obviously everyone on the floor and the coaching staff realizing that he's heating up. And that can open some things up for Steph Curry as well if the defense wants to try to double team Klay Thompson.
Here's Green. Again,
good opportunity there for Jeff Green.
That tough interior defense.
And Greg, that's exactly what he gives you. I mean, he's constantly making his presence felt around the rim.
It's Thompson off the drive.
I thought Klay Thompson was in the zone there. Pretty sure he'd knocked that one down.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Now here's Conley.
Conley had a chance there, but doesn't matter. Passes out to Zach Randolph for the jumper from about the free throw line area. And Randolph's got to get going here. He hasn't really done much this game.
Curry kicks to Green. Bogut against Gasol. Thompson in the corner.
Somebody get open for me, please. I threw that one away. Too much standing around on offense on that possession.
Gasol kicks to Conley.
Almost a steal there.
7 foot shot.
And a nice hook there from Zach Randolph.
Three on the bucket from Zach Randolph.
Just too dominant in the low post. Let him have the ball.
Pretty cool animation there.
Really simple opportunity for him.
Zach Randolph gets his team going. And Memphis finds themselves down only by three again.
Warriors leading by three.
Well, I tell you, the Warriors roster fit together hand in glove. They were led by the Splash Brothers, but the front court and the bench really complemented the rest of the team perfectly because all of the
nice move by Curry. A little bit of a shake and bake out there and a spin move to give himself a tiny bit of room to get that shot off.
Conley with it, picked up by Thompson.
Good pick there.
Draymond Green pulls it in.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The Dallas position, you could see the frustration on his face.
All right. And one opportunity here for Draymond Green, who goes absolutely psycho after knocking that one down. That was pretty cool. I like that sequence there.
Then you better be able to manufacture.
I'm not sure if that's some form of karate or just
Memphis also
letting loose.
Right comes in for Zach Randolph.
Well, that was pretty
Antonio
special.
Allen subbed in for Courtney Lee. Free throw good, Green. 1:52 left in the third quarter of the game. And it's Conley penetrating.
All right, nice block. Spates came over for the help defense. And Iguodala will just take that one home by himself. So a couple of explosive plays for Golden State after that mini run by Memphis. And they find themselves back up by 10. That's that fast-hitting defense, offense.
Barnes kicks to Iguodala. Spates the pass to Kerr. .119 left in the third quarter of the game. Six on the shot clock. All sorts of time.
Nicely done. Great ball movement on that possession. And it looks like Draymond was able to draw over an extra defender, freeing up Curry for a moment.
And there's no telling how big that lead's going to get. But a Again, it's just one game, but nonetheless, a very impressive one. The way they've handled
And here comes Matt Barnes.
John Livingston, he's checked in for Golden State. And the Grizzlies also with a sub. Barnes, he's
So you know that a technical foul is probably just around the corner. Actually, speaking about technical fouls, I've yet to see one in this game other than for a defensive 3 seconds. So I'll have to look and see how I can get one.
He feeds it to Livingston. Green against Gasol. And it's Green missing. And for Memphis, they're shooting at 46%, making some buckets. Gasol kicks to Barnes. Some nice passing there.
Oh, great. Great dunk there by Brendan Wright. And some good interior passing there to find him. Spates was not able to defend that one any better than he tried to.
Livingston kicks to Spates. The feed to Iguodala. It's stolen by Allen. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
So Memphis with a chance to pull this one back within 8 before the start of the fourth quarter.
It's his first trip to the line. First one falls for him. So both teams changing it up here.
I'm just checking out some details in the background. You could see Steve Curry was giving out some directives a few moments ago. And the crowd, as they have pretty much at every arena, they look pretty dead until the last part of the game.
Here is Livingston. Here's Barbosa.
Nice shot there by Barbosa right before the end of the third quarter. And Golden State will take a 10-point lead into the final quarter here.
Maybe difficult to overcome. The Warriors on top, leading by 10.
Got to give credit to Memphis, though, playing in this type of environment. They were able to get close a few times. But once Golden State goes on one of those runs, you know it's difficult for any team to really overcome.
Welcome back as we get set to start the fourth.
And I see we have some more people dropping in here to my live stream. So thanks everyone for joining. I really appreciate it. This is the YouTube channel One Life to Game. Playing NBA 2K16 for the Xbox One. And I invite you to like the video, comment, and subscribe.
And it's Udrich in at the point guard. Here's Azili.
Nice. Festus Azili comes in and finds a good opportunity to get on the scoring column after a nice pass by Klay Thompson.
Tipped away. And here's the fast break. The finish.
GFX Gaming is in the house watching the live stream. Welcome. Hope you're having a good time playing playing Madden. And thanks for stopping in to watch this video.
Following the score by Golden State.
So this thing's getting away from Memphis pretty quickly here. They're going to have to really open up their offense and just get a lot of three-point shots going to get back into this one.
Definitely help narrow the gap and maybe swing the momentum.
A little bit outside of Barbosa's range there, but Festus Azili got the offensive rebound, loses it. And Beno Udrih lays it in. He's had a pretty nice game. He's made an impact off the bench quite a few times already.
Ball pressure leading to the run out, man, it doesn't get much nicer than that. That is sweet, sweet stuff.
Now a timeout called by Golden State. Just watching Festus Azili out of Vanderbilt play. He's got the big body inside, moves pretty fluidly, adroit, good footwork. He's got a
up the whole package.
Yeah, he does. He's a space eater. He's very strong, physically good frame. He's low down there. What you said, the fact that he's fairly agile makes him tough.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hi, Kevin. Steve Kerr was just going over the plan with his team. His advice, clear cut. I want to see you playing to win, not playing not to lose. I don't care what the lead is. We do not back off.
Nice. Harrison Barnes there with a pump fake and gets around the defense for that dunk. Obviously, Harrison Barnes listened to the words of Steve Kerr, and he's not playing to lose, not after that dunk.
Conley kicks to Lee. Back to Conley. Offside Gasol. 14 feet away. That's in there. Conley with the assist.
Pretty good shot there by Marc Gasol, who's also been pretty quiet for the most part this game.
Missing a lot of games with various injuries from the knee and ankle a season ago. He can be a quality rebounder and rim protector, but he's got to find a way to stay healthy.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
And Azili, originally from Nigeria, picked up the game late. Only played 6 years of organized basketball before going pro. So still developing his hands and offensive skill set, but clearly, he's got the tools physically to play.
And take a listen into the crowd as they break out in a Warriors chant with 3 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
Free throw good, Green.
And that is a pretty cool detail there. I know that when I was playing the Cavaliers versus the Heat, if you have a chance to check that video out, you'll want to go ahead and do so.
Boy, perfect half at the free throw line for him.
When I was playing the Cavs against the Heat, the crowd at the Quicken Loans Arena started chanting "Beat the Heat," so I thought that was pretty cool. A nice little finger roll floater there by Stephen Curry. So that's great detail. The only thing is, I wish the crowd would do that earlier in the game too. It doesn't just have to be in the fourth quarter. There should be some different chants that the defense get there, that the crowd gets into, maybe saying defense or whatever, let's go team, whichever team it is. But it seems like that stuff only happens late in the fourth quarter. Draymond Green. He is lighting it up today, having a good time.
They give up a triple on an open look.
And GFX Gaming, to answer your question in the live stream, I just, save up money when I can to get these video games, and I'll play it for a little bit so I can put these videos together for you guys. And there's some games that I just, can't get into, and usually I'll just sell those on eBay or, take them back to GameStop and get some trading credit. And those games that I like, I'll hold on to a little bit more. So lately I've been playing this, FIFA 16 and Destiny. And I've actually been playing on my PS3 a lot lately too. Kind of some of the older games like Beyond Two Souls and Heavy Rain. I'm really into those kind of games too. But unfortunately my Elgato does not allow me to stream from the PS3. So I haven't been able to put those videos up, but thanks for the question though. So we're wrapping up this game here. We've got 2 minutes and 13 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. Golden State leads 52-39. And pretty much just want to waste the clock now. Nice shot by Zach Randolph. And you can see Steve Kerr got pissed off after that went in. Okay, I guess I'll have an easy take there.
When you can attack the basket as they do and work things inside close to the rim.
And folks, those are hops.
You just don't. So before we get to the end of the game here, if you're watching the live stream, tell me who you think should get the MVP this game. We'll find out shortly.
Michael Conley with excellent vision on that pass.
And Curry. And it's a dunkathon right now. Steph Curry is, he's just going right down the floor like this is practice. So you can't think that the Memphis coaching staff is too happy with this effort right now. They've pretty much conceded and are allowing Golden State to have whatever they want.
Outside Curry. He dishes it to Barnes.
And a lay-in there for Barnes.
And the Warriors lead by 15.
So Steph Curry has been involved in points in the last, what, three or four possessions for Golden State, in the sense of either getting him on his own or assisting.
No, Clark, their big advantage was points in the paint.
Well, they pounded that ball inside, Kevin, and operated down low. It worked for him consistently.
And when you look back at this one, what an amazing performance this was for Stephen Curry. He was extremely efficient offensively, got good looks, and really knocked down big shots all game long.
And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for the Warriors.
Boy, guys, I really like how they've driven the ball to the basket in this game. I mean,
yeah, that wasn't so as easy to shoot with Klay Thompson. The line reached the middle a little bit faster. And I think maybe I was accustomed to shooting free throws with Draymond Green.
Azili's checked in for Bogut.
A little bit better, but still need some work.
And it's Livingston in for Curry.
And remember, Klay Thompson's father, Michael Thompson, a former number one pick out of Minnesota. Growing up, he was the smallest.
All right, so let's see here. Bugs Bell, who is watching the live stream, has said Steph Curry will get the MVP of this game. And it's always hard to argue with that. He could probably get him on just about any game. But we definitely saw a nice performance out of Klay Thompson and Draymond Green as well. So they are certainly candidates that could get it. Yeah, GFX Gaming, you're right. 80 subscriptions right now, and I'm grateful to everyone, whether you subscribe or not, just for watching the video. I really appreciate everyone stopping by. But, you know, if you subscribe, that's great too, because you'll get more great content.
And right, here we go.
And just to let everyone know, I'm not sure if you're interested in this type of game, but tomorrow, so Sunday, September the 27th, LEGO Dimensions comes out. I will be getting the pack for the Xbox One. So come on by, because I will be doing an unboxing video, and then once I get the game going, I'll shoot some live stream and upload it as well.
Passes to Azili.
Fastest Azili with the shot from the elbow, and the crowd approves of that one. As we're wrapping this game up here, should be the final possession for Memphis.
Gave them plenty to cheer about and really use that home.
Unless I can zap down the floor here and get something real quick.
16 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Livingston. Iguodala, that's a two-pointer.
Why not? I mean, why not? That's the icing on the cake there. Over the last
few possessions. Clear case here, partner, of saving their best for last. Quite a run.
So we see the Warriors.
Okay, that'll do it, ladies and gentlemen, from the Oracle Arena. Golden State with a convincing victory here in a rematch of last year's Western Conference Finals. And Golden State takes it 63-45. And we'll head back to the studio here in a moment for the post-game coverage, along with the MVP selection. And a quick interview with Doris Burke first.
Yes, Kevin, thank you. I'm with Klay Thompson. You were able to really help out your team on the offensive end. What enabled such a big night of productivity for you?
I'm just used to the pace of the game by now, and my teammates do a good job of finding me when I'm open, so all credit goes to them. I just catch and fire when I'm open.
Thank you, Klay. We so appreciate it. Back to you, Kevin.
Doris, thank you as always. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. We'll see you later.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Welcome back, everybody. Ernie Johnson here along with Shaq and the Jet as we present our Jordan
Shaq cry?
Game, Stephen Curry. He made all the key plays every step of the way. They depend on him to deliver these sorts of performances, and he helped carry his team tonight.
I don't know if there's a fan base that loves their star more than this crowd.
Wow.
You get jealous, and he feeds off that support. Once they got behind him, he became unstoppable, man.
I will say this about Steph Curry. There is no player in the league more capable of single-handedly taking over a ball game than he is. What I mean is, Steph Curry's hot is hotter than anyone else is hot. He can beat you with his feet, his mind, his shot. The only thing you can be sure of is that he will beat you.
And that's it for our broadcast here tonight. But we're just
all right, everybody. Pretty cool here. I enjoyed playing this simulation game between Golden State and the Memphis Grizzlies.
I'm Ernie Johnson.
So thanks for tuning in to One Life to Game. It's been a pleasure. I'll be back on later with some more content. And comment, like, please, and subscribe. See you guys on a future video. Thanks so much for viewing. It means a lot. What's happening, everybody? Welcome back to One Life to Game. Very happy to have you back here with another NBA 2K16 video for the Xbox One. This time we will be doing a rematch of the Western Conference Finals from last season, where we will have the Golden State Warriors hosting the Memphis Grizzlies. Really excited for this one. Hope you are as well. So thanks so much for tuning in. I will be controlling the Golden State Warriors. And let's go ahead to the studio for the pregame show. Enjoy, everybody. Thanks so much for watching.
The 2K Sports Pregame Show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. Tonight, it'll be the Golden State Warriors going up against the Memphis Grizzlies. And for Memphis, they're looking to come out strong and make their mark early. They have to look at this game as a great opportunity to do just that. And Klay Thompson, the son of former first overall pick Michael Thompson, I mean, when he gets hot, he can take over games.
And you know what? This guy, didn't he have 37 in one
quarter
last year? How incredible is that to get 37 in a quarter?
Not only that, Kenny also had 26 in a quarter later on.
Get out of here.
Yeah, he can shoot over anyone with his height, and he has a quick release. You know, he probably has the prettiest shot in the game.
I would agree with that.
37 and a quarter.
Right.
And your career high was?
41.
41 is your career high. 37 and a quarter. Right. Does that impress Shaquille O'Neal?
Yeah.
What's your high in a quarter?
I don't know. I didn't get the ball that much. You know who I played with.
Shaq is great in this game. As he is in real life.
I heard you, Shaq. I heard you.
I could be subliminal.
Let's get it to Kevin Harlan.
He didn't get the ball that much.
I didn't get it to him.
It's the Western Conference on display, featuring the Memphis Grizzlies. The excitement of the NBA is on the way. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony.
So I'm excited as I've been playing this game a little bit more in the past few days, just to see now that I've got a fantastic point guard on my team.
And Steph Curry, a player within the gym range, told us about his comfort stretching the floor.
Anywhere 5-6 feet outside that three-point line, if I have a dribble, if I catch and shoot, if I have a good look, you know, I think Coach allowed me to take that shot. And it's tough to guard, especially when you see a couple go in. That basket gets a lot bigger.
I was going to say, Greg, how big must that hoop look to Steph Curry and tough to guard might be the understatement of the day.
I mean, he is just an insanely great shooter. I mean, arguably, I don't think there's an argument. He's the best shooter in the world. The argument is whether or not he's the best shooter ever.
Ever.
And listen, I can imagine there's very few times that Coach Kerr is not going to allow this Splash brother to let her rip.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And the Warriors, guys, what jumps out to you in this game, stats-wise?
Really active hands early on here as they're able.
So as we get the second quarter started here in Oakland, I'd like to try to get Klay Thompson involved. He didn't really get too much action early in the game, so we'll see if I can get anything to him without forcing it.
And it's Conley in at the point guard position. Now here's Thompson, four on the clock.
Oh, that was a pretty good attempt there. Just didn't fall through for me.
This mindset that Golden State wins through offense, but their defense, you know, Gia, you were talking about this, is where the true strength of this team lies.
Yeah, I think that's what's really allowed them to separate.
Pretty nice defense being played here by Golden State, forcing Memphis into some contested low percentage shots here early on.
Now here's Thompson. Jeff Green missing his last shot. Thompson, left side.
There we go.
Thompson's got the lead up to six now for the Warriors.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense.
It looks like we got a timeout here by Memphis. And Klay Thompson psyched up to score his first shot get his first shot in the second quarter. See, that's kind of generic, because I've seen this assistant coach, I'm assuming that is. I don't know if that's supposed to be me. I don't know who that is, but I've seen that guy in multiple teams, that same exact dude. So maybe somebody can comment on that. Is that supposed to be the person that you are, or is that just a generic assistant coach? To see if I can have some better control with him, do some better passing to get everyone involved. So we got the tip off here, and that's one by Bogut. And oddly, we have Draymond Green bringing the ball up the floor.
A lot of defense with Conley and Lee.
So let's see how things go this game.
At the pivot spot, manning the middle.
that's a good sign of things to come if Harrison Barnes can get to the hoop that easily on this Grizzlies defense. Nice little start here for Golden State, up 2-0 with 4:40 left to play in the first quarter.
Clark looking around the league. There's no team that teams want to.
I like those Klay Thompson big heads in the background there. Quick steal.
Brand of basketball, they play hard. Everybody's on the same page.
And Courtney Lee takes it right back for Memphis.
How they try to wear you down.
Now here's Lee.
Little flop there by Klay Thompson. Another steal.
And here we go. Thompson heading to
there we go. Easy fast break there. Opportunity for Klay Thompson.
Really deflating for a team to cough.
So two quick dunks for Golden State to get up to this 4-0 lead.
Feels like giving up two baskets to one.
And you know the crowd at the Oracle Arena would be electrified after that. Probably some of the best fans in the NBA.
Part of it is that they just have a style that matches up well.
Jeez. Jeff Green looks like he's sweating as if we've played about four quarters and are in overtime right now. Ooh.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. Jeff Green picks one up.
Look at that spin move there.
With the Memphis Grizzlies, I mean, there isn't a team that gives them too much trouble anywhere.
Let's break down the defense a little bit.
They're used to playing in tight, low-scoring games, and they create that situation with their deliberate style.
And Steph Curry, 6'3", and about 195. I mean, a slender frame. You look back to...
Look at that realism before I shoot the free throw here. Oh, Steph Curry is playing with the mouth guard. That is definitely him. So this game does not miss too much.
Worked up and bulked himself up. He's added some muscle. He even got up to 200 pounds, I think he said. But he didn't feel real good, Clark, at that weight.
Yeah, it's not about the weight, Kevin. It's about strength. You need it to fight through screens and attack the rim, and he's clearly put on the strength he needs to play at his highest level.
And remember, you go back to when Steph Curry was in college, more of a shooting guard at Davidson, but he's worked relentlessly.
Memphis works the ball inside to Zach Randolph. A little bit of a ticky-tack foul there, but Zach Randolph. Oh, unselfish play by Curry, but Draymond Green either missed the dunk or it was deflected.
Makes it off the glass.
And Memphis converts on that turnover there by me. Hanging in the game. Pretty fast-paced start here. And you'd expect nothing less from these Western Conference teams, especially the Warriors, as we've reached our first timeout break at the Oracle Arena.
Decide to take their first timeout here.
And you are watching NBA 2K16 for the Xbox One.
Carve out space, the space he needs to play well.
Yeah, he's unorthodox with extreme
patient offense. I'm not sure that's really two words you ever see correlated together with the Golden State Warriors, but we'll let it ride for now. So we got Sean Livingston checking in. The NBA Finals MVP, Andre Iguodala. We've got Barbosa. So Golden State continues to attack you with firepower and athleticism at all times. As you see Leandro Barbosa get to the basket there for a layup, using his quickness to get around the defense.
Great playground, old school there, partner.
Here's Hudrick. The Warriors making the shot. Right sets a screen.
And Beno Udrih with the layup there.
Well, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like that.
It's like a running game in football. When you can pound the basketball inside, it also allows you to control the team's transition.
Pretty happy last year for Sean Livingston for him to not only get back from his injury. And then looks like he's found a nice home here with the Warriors. And for him to get a championship ring was a nice moment for him, I'm sure. A lot of hard work to get back onto the floor. And a quick 4 points for Beno Udrih, as he was able to get open there on that screen.
Here is Livingston. He's guarded by Udrih. Here's the three.
A little overzealous on that shot. And we've reached the end of the first quarter with Golden State leading 16-12 on NBA 2K16 for Xbox One. This is One Life to Game. Thanks a lot for watching. Definitely give me those thumbs up if you've enjoyed the video, and I would greatly appreciate it. Will head to the line for two. Draymond Green picks that foul up. So yeah, definitely take an opportunity to comment on the video. Write anything, you know, let me know who your favorite NBA team is. Let me know what you think about this video or about the game as a whole. Maybe things that you've noticed that you like about the game. Definitely want to hear a lot of feedback from the viewers, so write in and subscribe. Please subscribe. I'd love to have you guys come back for future videos.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
Zach Randolph getting up there in his mid-30s, but his game has never been based on explosiveness. So it's all about strength, skill, and craft when you talk about Zebo, and he's aging gracefully.
Now here is Bogut.
Somebody want to try to get open there? Nope. Bad pass by me, though, that cross-court pass.
Here's Lee. Off the break.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
So we're all tied up here at six with about 3 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Pretty low scoring here for these explosive teams.
And Randolph Clark can struggle in matchups against quicker power forwards of those spread fours.
Nice shot there by Draymond Green. Zach Randolph displays a little frustration letting that one go. 9-6 lead here for Golden State. Not typically the guy you'd see taking the early three-point shot in the game for Golden State, but still capable of making them.
Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. Here's Curry. And it's Gasol with the rebound. The Grizzlies trail by three. Outside Conley. There's the triple.
Lucky that he didn't make that one, because I wasn't really playing great defense in that possession.
Curry with it. Outside Green. Outside for Curry.
Great passing by Bogut out of the post there to find an open Steph Curry. Just needed a little bit of room to hit that three. And it looks like we're going to have some substitutions get ready to check in a moment here. Not sure why Gasol didn't attack the hoop on that one. I gave him a wide open lane. Nice trip by the big man.
And now Curry running the floor all by himself.